Welcome to the Electric Supercar channel. Today is a special day. I bet you don't know what day it is. It is Take Your Homemade Supercar to Work Day. I'll bring you along. Alright, so plan is to take this into work this week. A couple things, I guess you can't see it, but I need to work on the roll hoops, put the panels in, fiberglass them in, and kind of pretty them up. The other thing I'm going to be working on is kind of this door panel, just the fit. So probably some grinding, filling, sanding. There are a couple other things. I'm going to call this suspension settling. We're a little tight here. Like I can barely fit one finger in. Can't get two in. So I'm going to raise the car up, take the wheels off, raise up the suspension, put the wheels back on. Other than that, there's just areas like this where I had a little crack and kind of did some maintenance and I've just never fixed it up. So I'm going to be doing some touch-up things. Might break out a can of white paint. Not that that's the final color, but just kind of want to get things looking a little better. You know, just places like this. So a couple prep things before we take it to work. I am trying to fit in, these are the, I think I call them roll hoop arches, so underneath. And I've also got these other panels that kind of go in there to kind of cover them up. And surprise, surprise, they don't fit very well. They're also extremely hard to get in. So underneath here, I've got the battery box. And so I think normally they're supposed to lift in from underneath. So it's a little challenging just to get access, but then even when they're in, I got this huge gap, so I'm trying to figure out how I can make it go up a little bit more. And then this one's got to go in as well, and I figure this one will probably have some gaps too. So we'll see. My thought is when this is all in place, I'll probably put some short strand fiberglass filler over the seam and kind of sand it all smooth. But that's kind of what it looks like. Okay, after some trimming, this is about what we've got. So again, just a little gap, and that'll actually work well just for putting in some of that fiberglass filler, kind of give it some bite, and on this back side as well. So I've got both these kind of ready. These other panels go in, but I think I have to take out the seats to do that one, so I might wait. It's just kind of a pain to get the seats in and out. All right, I've got these clamps holding this underside in place, and I'm gonna go ahead and get some short strand fiberglass filler and kind of fill in the joints. Got this kind of all the short strand fiberglass filler, so it's kind of all together, one piece now, and just sanded it a little bit. It still needs kind of filler and a lot of other stuff to make it look good. That's kind of what the back looks like. Kind of same story, just needs more filler and things. So I do have another panel that kind of goes here. I'm not sure quite how it fits in. It's kind of really challenging. I might need to take out the seats. I got a generic car cover for about $25. I've been typically putting this tarp over it, and the main reason is just when I do a lot of sanding or other things, I just don't want it to get kind of on the interior. To be honest, I don't want anything exterior either, but yeah, it fits pretty good. There is the back. All right, I'm trying to look at the panels that go underneath the roll hoops. That's these guys, and I failed Tetris. So this has got a big end on one side and a big end on the other side. And I cannot for the life of me figure out how this is supposed to go in, because essentially you can't go in from underneath. You can't really angle it in. So basically what I had to do is I ended up cutting it. So, not a big deal. I'm used to slicing and splicing panels. So now this guy can go in. The challenge is, it like just is not a very close fit, which probably should not be surprising to me by now. But We'll have to kind of build that up so it looks good and fit on the other side. Okay, I've been sanding and sanding and sanding the roll hoops. They're looking okay. They're not the best, but they are in place, and kind of all the seams and stuff are looking pretty good. On the front, I still need to do some more. I need to take the access panel off and kind of really get to the front, but we'll save that for another time. Who knew you could go through so much sandpaper, though? All right, kind of filled in some of the gaps. It's looking a little better. Did the same thing on the other side. Okay, I am coming to work at a time where there's not very many people. One of the reasons is I want to see if I can get into our parking garage because it's got some speed bumps. So I'll show you. So there's the speed bump. What do you think? Think we fit? I don't think we do. We'll see. All right, we are so close, but we do scrape. So we can kind of go over. I'll let you listen. You hear that? So we kind of scrape a little bit, and that's enough where I think, nope, can't go this way. Okay, I'm gonna take the car into work. Because I don't really have at-home charging right now, they do have chargers at work. I'm hoping that everything still works. So I'm gonna drive it there, hope that it charges. And that'll be good. All right, super bright outside, but made it all the way to work. I got it plugged in. It was a little, I don't know, first time charging, so I had a couple learning things to do, but now it's charging. All right, here we are charging at work. Super convenient. Let me charge 4 hours for free. Yeah, so I just had to get on my ChargePoint app, tap it. I had to tap something on my phone as well as here, but then we got charge ports unlocked and started charging, and it says we're charging.
Yeah, so, how did you get one?
Yeah, like, do you just
there are
buy
companies
them from McMaster or something? Like
eBay. So basically all these come from like a wrecked Tesla.
That's a big motor. Yeah, that's a big electric motor.
Well,
so
what
about
is,
the
so this side is the inverters. This side
yeah, it was
like
where
empty.
I was going next.
That's the motors. Like all this is just like electronics, like hollow.
So it's only that big.
That's the motor.
Ah.
And that beats my giant F-350 mega gasoline
yeah,
engine.
So this one's got 475 kilowatts, which is 637 horsepower.
Wow.
How?
And the battery, where's the battery from?
So the battery modules are from the Chrysler Pacifica.
Okay.
And, so the hybrid minivan, I think, has four modules, and this car got 12, so it's got 32 kilowatt hours.
Okay.
And so that should give me about 100, maybe 150 mile range.
Cool.
Better than that, use the battery modules.
Got the awesome seat belts for the racing car seats. Suspension was all part of the kit.
Yeah.
This would be fun to climb over a speed bump.
So is this a video, this whole thing?
It is.
Hi, Charity.
Hi. How long have you been driving it around? Like, how long has it
been? I got it registered last week.
Okay.
Right. So do you want to paint it or something? What do you mean? This is final.
I'm sure you already said this, but when was the your first, like, when did you start working on this?
It's about 2 years ago.
Okay. I don't know how to do this.
It's impressive. In 2 years,
I don't know how to do any of this.
Looks good, Jeremy. A lot of work.
This looks awesome. Like, so good.
Have you let your kids drive it?
Your daughter?
Thanks for showing it off.
Has anyone else besides you?
Yes. So Zach from Jerry Rig Everything.
That's right.
And he brought it back. That's really nice of him.
Could you put a gas engine in this, I guess?
It was designed to go with a Honda Accord drivetrain.
Okay. Was this the first car that you've ever built?
Yes.
Really?
Yes. Before this, my expertise level was changing spark plugs.
What inspired you to build it?
I was telling Charity, I've always wanted to get into cars. I like cars, right? It sounds cool, but it's I've never really done anything.
Sure.
So I was always looking for a kit car or something to build. But for me, one of the things that always kind of stopped me was, again, you wanted to spend all this time and effort driving a Honda Accord. It's like, well, I want to have something better than that.
You say you made it really challenging just for the sake of adding actually things, or
I'm not very good. If there's a hard way to do it, I will find it. It's the dash as an iPad.
Oh, no way!
Okay.
And a touch screen thing that you can control it.
Touch screen, yeah.
So, how many percent done?
Well, it's 100% done, meaning you can drive it. Anybody that works on cars knows that it's never really done. The other thing, working on a car, you realize very quickly that, cars, they spend a lot of time and design and testing everything. Like the glove box. It's that's this trunk took me forever. The windshield wipers. I can't tell you how difficult these things are. You get the linkages right, do this, try to make sure it doesn't bend. Oh, I gotta change. Simple things like windshield wipers, door locks. Yeah, it takes a long time, so it really makes you appreciate your car. You get in, you just don't even think about it.
What are the taillights?
They are just taillights.
From the kit?
Not from anything. Okay,
oh, I see. Yeah, they look nice because they looked like big Lexus or something.
So it's not carbon fiber, it's just
just dip it.
You didn't watch the video. It was actually a cool video, you should watch it.
Yeah, the door inserts also from something, right?
No. So I had to learn how to do vinyl wrapping, so everything that you see that's wrapped is stuff that I've done. Some of it's better than others.
So the door panel was fiberglass and then
it looked like this.
Yeah.
What's the windscreen?
I
mean, they must provide
Honda Accord.
It's a Honda Accord windscreen?
Yeah. It's like a 1994 to 97.
Not cut down or anything, but
yeah, this is just so that's nice. I mean, if I get a crack or chip, I can go get a windshield.
So when they designed the car, they started with the windscreen.
Yeah, everything is meant to be from a Honda Accord.
So the rear cradle here is all right out of the Tesla, right?
Yes. Yeah, so the whole subframe is from the Tesla.
That's good. Where's the vent?
Vin's up here on the frame. It's right here.
Okay.
Well, how'd you get a vin?
When you buy the kit.
Got it. It's a vin number. So it's actually legal to drive on the road now?
Yeah. On a license.
That's cool. But that felt good.
Didn't have to pass much mission.
Hey, people can have different styles.
No. Not when it comes to sports cars. You've got to make that thing look good.
Yeah, it just blows me away.
Those tires are just massive.
Oh, I know.
Hey, you want to see it move?
Yeah.
You're just looking relative to the foot.
Might be one of the joints.
That's where it's cool, but it's not because you don't know what it's on.
Where do you even start it up?
Quiet.
That's so unfair.
I bet you could try it. I bet you could blast past cops. I'll bet you can go 20 miles over the speed limit and never notice.
Yeah.
I like the wheel choice. Yeah, the wheels look good. Yeah, that's a nice choice. Thank you.
am going to be doing an episode soon where I kind of cover just things I've learned, what I wish I knew when I started. So if you guys got some specific questions you'd like answered, please put them in the comments below. I did want to answer one question now. There's a lot of people saying, you know, I'm going to be sad when this is done. What will you do next? There will be another build. Stay tuned. Thank you for coming with me to take your homemade supercar to work day. Next week, we are going to do a challenge and a product giveaway. It'll be something better than a t-shirt. So stay tuned. See you next week.